Greetings, it's Don Sly, sitting in my car. I'm getting tuned up before I play some blues tonight at Max Nightclub. I'm in Eugene. Dos trantos a días, drontos antrantas, dos antratos, dos antritos. Drosa fatia trotos, dros fatia tras, contra tos fatra, dros fatios, dros fatuos fatuatis vo, dros fatro, dros fatro. Dros fantrantas fadras, dos fantrantos fatian, dos antrantos trara, antros santos val, dos fantrantos faran, dos fantrantos faran, brontos fatratuara, antros fantrantos. Dos avantia, dos vantia tratua, dos vantratua, dos vantriotua, la 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 la. Van trantos fa, drontos fa trotiva, dos van truta tra, and dos van trota, untros van tra, dos van trantos fa trias, atros fa tuva. It's what's on the radio. I'm sitting in my car. I'm outside of the Veterans Building here, which you don't have to be a veteran to be a part of it. It's free. You can just come here, and there's dancing, and there's playing music, and there's a lot of playing of blues. That's why I'm here. I'm tuning up before it's time to go and play my saxophone. I'm smoking legal medical marijuana. Do you know what's really interesting is that I'm consulting an attorney about my family matters because I haven't seen my daughter for almost a year on the show with Steve Urkel about legal things because I haven't seen my daughter for almost a year. My birth daughter, because I've been listed as a male on my stuff and I'm her birth mama. She has two moms on her birth certificate. And I was told my parental rights were terminated, and I'm like a master's level therapist, and I'm Cherokee, and so is my daughter, and they didn't once talk to the tribe about this, and for some interesting reason, Lane County, where I live in Eugene, is the only county that shows that I have had my rights terminated, but all the other counties, I'm fine, and I'm actually listed as a provider and receiving money for services, some social work services at other DHS offices at the same time. So go figure that one out. Don Sly LCSW Incorporated is receiving money and I'm not the one doing it. So there's a few things to look at and I'm patiently waiting to see my daughter. I am going to be going up to Kaiser tomorrow because I'm gonna be getting a good deal on an Xbox, an Xbox S. I'm gonna wait to get the big one for Christmas because I understand in December of this year there's gonna be a brand new Xbox, but it has a lot of games and it has a lot of cool things with it, and so I'm gonna drive up there and also check out the used instruments too, because I'm looking for a 12-string guitar, an acoustic electric guitar, and if you happen to know who the fuck I am and you're interested in me and you're around, you could come check me out, because that's where I'm going to be at tomorrow at 5. Don't get too excited. I've been touring guitar centers for well over a year and a half now on the crazy. Well, at first I had the Prius and now the Lexus, and people thought it was pretty silly, but I shot a lot of really good videos. Did Erda die, but hopefully I got attention somehow. I'm watching because I'm right outside the club, waiting to go in. I don't smoke marijuana with my child in the car. The only time I've ever had her in my vehicle without a car seat, which I suspect by now, the next time I see her, she's probably way too big for that booster seat. She probably does not require one. But by now, maybe she has a sibling that does. So I keep it around, just in case. And, she, rode in my car without a car seat sometimes when I would take her back and forth from my mom and dad's house, because we lived on a country lane and it was a half a mile long, and the dude who reported it turned out to somehow end up being a sheriff, at least, I don't know. Part of me has suspected it was just printed up in a fake newspaper for my reaction, because I can't believe they would pick this dude. But it's the same exact road that he drives his children in the back of his pickup to the river without restraints. And so if we want to get all pointing fingers at everybody, technically the road that it's on in Crestwell is legally a road. It's paved. It has a name. I grew up with it gravel and, you know, sitting on people's laps while we drove up and down, and driving tractors when I was, you know, 9 and 10 and 11 and that kind of stuff. So, where he reported seeing my child not being in a car seat is the same place he takes his children not with seat belts in the back of a pickup, which is also not street legal. So, if we want to get all picky about it, we can do that. And then we can move on to fun things. So I'd like to get my daughter back so I could be doing things. I've gotten a teensy bit of money. I'm hoping that it's the first payment, because it's not as much money as what I was expecting, and I'm hoping it's the first payment and what I'm owed. I think it's my turn to go play. And, oh no, they're still playing. So, I think I'm still owed a little bit of money from the federal government, and I'm hoping that Elizabeth Warren is watching, because I know that she's going to come check it out, because I'm going to be really good. It's going to be good to check in on what's going on with me, because if they're able to, like, mess with me to the extent that I've been messed with and I've been able to crawl out of it, there could be a lot learned from that, and there could be things changed, and also, I could get what I'm actually owed instead of them taking a third and pretending it's going to an attorney that I represented myself, and all sorts of things. There's lots of issues, and people who care about it fucking know. I don't want to bore the rest of you. It's gotten to the point where I've kept track of a lot of things, and I was supposed to be disappeared or dead or missing or some shit, and I'm still here, and I am prioritizing my money in a way that is going to really talk for who I am, because I'm paying off my debt first. I'm not running off to buy lap dances or prostitutes or, you know, big crack things of meth. I don't even know where to buy meth, but I could be living with a dealer and not know, because I'm just really, I stay to my own business. I'm not into meth at all. It makes me go to sleep anytime I've ever gotten a stimulant, right to sleep. So it's very much a waste on Don's eye. I do very well with medical marijuana. So I've put my deck out as a social worker and got blacklisted because like came out about using marijuana, and people thought I was going wild because it was legal in 2015. I was filmed at Grateful Dead reunion shows smoking out, and came back to my job as a contractor for an agency where they treat people for alcohol and drug issues and mental health issues, and some of them didn't like it, and they didn't talk to me about it up front, but they did squeeze me out pretty quickly. At that same time, I like recalled a whole bunch of early childhood trauma, and had to go on leave because I started to have flashbacks at work and thought armed people were coming, and something apparently along those lines happened to me when I was little, and other deals. And my I'm an early childhood specialist, and so, you know, I put myself on leave pretty quickly. I did some partial work, and then eventually I documented the hell out of everything because that's just what I do. And you know, I look back and I know exactly what happened. Is in March of 2017. Well, first, in March of 2017, on my fit show on Periscope TV, I have done 3 seasons worth, and it was the 2nd season, I believe. I was really frustrated because my family kicked me out that year. In March, because I started talking about my brother and just my sister's boyfriend sexually assaulting me, and the police wouldn't take a report, and nobody in my family wanted to hear it, and suddenly I'm getting an eviction from my parents' upstairs bedroom, like my sister's bedroom where I grew up, and they're charging me $40,000 or $50,000 for laundry and food and stuff like that, and acting like it's a thing, and that the sheriff's gonna, you know, take all my things if I'm gonna go to jail if I don't get out of there. And that was the last day I worked, because I had to go to a training that was several hours away, and I didn't see many of my things ever again. They didn't ever let me come back and get them. And they started to talk really bad about me, and after that, a few months after that, I don't remember the exact date, but I went and bought, with my Discover card, I bought 10 medical squibs at Cherry City Dispensary in Salem, Oregon, and they're each about less than 1,000 milligrams each of THC, and I ate 10 of them while I was on camera and streaming it live to whoever the fuck was watching that day, and I drove over and ate some Chinese food. And I drove from Salem to Eugene, and the whole point was to show how, not that I was advocating other people to take that amount, because that amount would put most people to sleep. You can't overdose on marijuana, but you can get sick. You can feel not very good at all, and that many is too many for most people. But I've been using marijuana since I was 13, and I've had a medical marijuana card since I was since 1999, and I'm 49 years old now, so it's been quite effective, to the point of that I've been attacked by everybody possible that knew what I was doing to make me look unsuccessful, so they could say, look, that stoner can't do a thing, where, you know, when I was working for that agency at the Grateful Dead Showtime, where they, you know, encouraged me to be on leave, I was making between $8,000 and $12,000 a month from just that particular agency, because I was billing 80% of the billable rate as a contractor. There's a lot of things I could go into details. They had a fellow contractor, a psychiatrist, evaluate me and say that I have to take 5 different drugs he prescribed, because he thought I was psychotic due to using marijuana, and that I had to follow all of his recommendations or I wouldn't be able to have my job. And, you know, within a month I was out of there, and they needed somebody else to do it. And I think they kept using my information without me. But I'm owed some money by a lot of people, and I've been living in my car homeless for a couple of years. I have had the same place for 6 months now, but it's not my 100% pick, because it's just not my favorite. There's some issues. I don't want to go into tons of detail right now, but like, I wouldn't want my daughter to be there. I want my own place for that. But, and I can get my own place for that but I'm still paying over $1,000, $1,300 a month for my two home loans on the home that I own in a little small town just south of Eugene. Because nobody will help me run the people out of there. Whoever's living there, and I suspect my daughter's part of it, has been there on my dime since November, thinking that somebody else is paying it, and it's me. And I don't even have a key, and all my things are in there, unless they took them to Goodwill or sold them on eBay, I don't know. But I'm hoping that I don't have to do all this attorney stuff, and that I could just have my daughter back, and, a nice place to stay until I figure out what's going on with my house. For all I know, it's been ruined and condemned or rented out to people. I don't really know, and I don't even want to think about what could possibly be wrong for me to not be able to get in there like I should be. But I'm hoping that sometime somebody actually hears me and I don't sound like the crazy bitch yammering on and on, because I'm really not the only one that this is happening to now either. And other people are just as good at talking and explaining what's happening to them in this county, and it's becoming harder to take people's homes and their cars and use their things while they're in jail and write down all their account information so you can take your trips to Sun River and your ski trips and all those things, still have somebody else pay for it. It's not so cool. Hey, how are you? Good. It smells good. Huh? Are you playing again?
I didn't play before.
Are you playing now?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay. Me too.
So cool.
Yeah. I like this. It's silicone?
It's close in the dark.
No way.
Yeah. But this really.
Haunted pipe. The haunted pipe, so when the light goes out, you can see
it. It doesn't. It won't come out easily, but it comes out easily. Like when you peel it out.
Is it easy to clean?
That's what makes it easy. Well, that's.
Because you just have to soak
it. What I did yesterday is I put hot water in it and I like wiped out the inside, but you can clean it with alcohol.
Oh, okay.
Here, you want any more? You can just get back to you or whatever.
I'll just take another token. I have to go set up my horn.
I can't even have to get a cigarette while talking to you. You don't want to smoke out front.
Oh, I know.
People find reputation in the best club.
That's right. We need a little hut.
Like
shit, they had a smoking hut when I was in high school.
Here?
Back then, they would just put a little hut for the kids that were old enough to be like, just smoke
more?
It over there.
You want
more? That tastes really fruity. What kind is that?
Might be the platinum huckleberry cookies.
It's really good.
Yeah. Is she done with it? I'll just catch it up.
It's close. Good lord.
Thursday?
Tuesday.
Yeah. Even a dead spot like me can tell. Oh, how you doing?
I'm doing okay. How are you doing?
somehow, I'm definitely on the upswing, which is a good thing.
That's how I am, too, because I can't get any fucking lower.
I hate it when that happens.
Yeah, well, I'm coming back from dental. I had to have the very back molar extracted a few weeks ago, and that was
even worse.
It was infected, and it was horrible.
Yeah, all I got is brain trouble. You got...
But it's feeling better now. It's feeling better.
You don't look too bad, so...
I had a chipped tooth I had to get filled yesterday, but they did a beautiful job. It's like I'm fighting in my sleep or something. I have no idea. I wish I had a good story for it. I brush my teeth regularly.
You're living where there's no,
this is where the free saxophones are at, huh? Yeah, what do you play? What type of horn do you play?
This is a Selmer Mark 7.
Oh, I had a Selmer Mark 6.
Oh, yeah.
When I was a kid.
Uh-huh.
And I sold it in the 70s for like $300.
Oh, wow. I got this I got in 1987 for, it was about $3,500 then.
And my mom, I saw my mom in October, and she said, "Oh yeah, we paid $75 for that."
Oh wow! You made a good turnaround too, anyway.
In those days, it was like $1,000.
Oh yeah.
What's your name?
I'm Dawn.
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 Rich. Nice to see you here. I've seen you here a few times playing.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna play some now.
Cool. You aren't going out?
Yeah,
you guys play like gigs. What's that?
I don't get many. I was together with another horn player one day, and we were like, "Shit, man!" He was like, "Shit, man! I haven't had any gigs since Paul was dead." I said, "And when I got here, Paul was already here. I haven't had any gigs. We'd really like to hate him, but he's the nicest cat we've ever met."
It's Mark's nightclub, and you join him.
He's just a sweetheart.
I hardly know him.
You want to do it?
Yeah.
Hey, listen.
I have enough money to pay debt, not enough money to do anything else.
We had a lot of musicians coming in tonight.
I did eat well tonight.
And there are a lot of musicians that accommodated other musicians so that everybody gets a shout tonight. We want to commend all these players for giving up part of their set or whatever they're doing to make the whole thing work for us. Thank you so much. And it's a pleasure to have Blue Owens with us. He's splitting the set with Bill Spirey. Anyway, thank you guys for being so accommodating.
Did I become a saxophone player?
All right. We're learning.
I've been one before.
B. What song did you want to do?
Greg Bowers.
Greg
Bowers.
B?
Yeah.
So,
get it. Thank you. 2017. The arrest me delayed in March 2019, and it was filmed. They tried to pretend like it was 2017. Their idea of time travel.
2 years?
Ready when you are.
Thank you. For Mr. Blue Owens, kind of sitting there, man.
Give it up for Blue. Can you get that?
Which button do you push to make the movie?
To incorporate them into a tattoo of a butt on a butt on a butt on a butt until they're too tiny to see. You could substitute garbanzo beans anywhere in there for that. I know if I hold it too close, I look like a cone head. If I don't put my hair back, I hear that you can't see my face. In my mind, like, nobody ever fucking comments or tells me anything, but I just imagine that. I haven't had a haircut in a long time. I'm kind of Tarzan right now. Maybe that should change. I don't know. I usually have a little bit of blonde up in there, but I'm 4 years poor. This is 4 years poor hair. So they handcuffed me 2 years later, like they arrested me for that thing in the Prius, and I was driving a 2000 Lexus.
Sing.
Okay. I spent 11 days in jail for no reason. And I videoed the so-called arrest where they didn't read me my rights and they took my last 4 of my social security.
Down.
on the ground. Give it up for the fire man, please.
Robert Blair. Robert Blair, everybody. We got one more from Bill Spivey, and then we got one more from Aaron Daniels, and we're all of a set. Yeah.
The question is still outstanding.
Hoochie, man, in A. And who's going to play her?
In A. I feel eligible.
Eligible.
Thank you.
One more time, let me hear it from you, Fat Tuesday 2020. All right, give it up for Drake. And everybody serving you tonight. All right, give it up for all these great, great, great musicians. Mike Scagnelli over on the keyboards. Byron Case on the bass. Bill Spirey on vocals and harmonica. We had, let's see, we had Ron Smith on the drums. We had Blue, not only Blue, but Blue on the harmonica duties. Mike Scagnelli on the keyboards. Don Sly on saxophone. Jamie Misley on guitar and vocal. Robert Blair, you were listening to. We have one more set for you. Please stick around, drink up, order up, and have a good time. All right, Alex Huber is in the house. Okay.
Skip on the marquee the next 2 nights.
Okay. All right. Nate Smith looks like he's coming up. Alex Huber is in the house. Billy Blue is slated for this set, and Chris Stone.
Mä sen tieträt, jos sä pakat tieträt samaa. Mä en päin tieträt, jos sä pakat tieträt. Mä sä tieträt, jos sä pakat tieträt, jos sä pakat. Mä sä tieträt. You got to work the big ones, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, old man.
Hey, are you leaving?
Yeah.
Are you heading back to your house?
Yeah.
You think you can drop me off closer?
I can drop me off closer.
All right, I'm gonna go down.
A mae sy'n diodred diwydiad pan mae'n dregyd yn dod yn diodred a os yw peth i'n dregyd sy'n mynd i'n drenio sy'n. So I ate like 10 medical squibs. It's almost 1,000 milligrams of THC, which is a lot of marijuana. Not that I wanted to advertise that that's what you were supposed to do, even though they were created by an Oregon out of Bend, a Bend, Oregon company. Lunchbox makes the squibs. Lunchbox Alchemy. And I once in my mind named them Munchbox because I'm a lesbian. And I think it cost them a few
a few orders, but I don't know. Maybe they should just save them for Pride Day or something. But anyway, I have PTSD, and I was doing that day, and I broadcast it on my Periscope TV. It was at Real Dawn Sly. They blocked that. It was after March 2017. It was June, I believe, and when I got all the 10 squibs on the Discover card, it was just showing that that's what's effective for me and that I've been withheld from. They'd actually been giving me hemp and non-medicated marijuana, and so I was overdue for it. It kind of just absorbed into me. And I videoed that demonstration. I didn't have any type of driving impairment. Nobody pulled me over until 2 years later, when they suddenly thought that they could just arrest me after a night of filming for 4 hours straight for 3 different telecasts. I filmed for 4 hours straight. Everything that I did, including sitting in my car telling a funny story after I drove televised from one place to another, Eugene to Springfield, not driving any marijuana, not smoking marijuana in my car. And they told me I had an arrest warrant out in Florence, which I did not, and just picked me up. I don't really want to go into details about what they did next, because it's actually in court right now. And it's, I'm going to keep quiet about it, because I'd like to make my money on that one. So, anyway, I have fresh trauma. And they pretended like I went to prison instead of jail, so they had prison rules in jail. And I've never been to jail, so I had no fucking clue. The night, everything that they did with the lights and the food, and we even got the, to order food just like you would there, and I stayed there for long enough to get the shirt that goes underneath the scrub top. So I know a few things that I really shouldn't know, because my record is clean, but they thought it would look like I was doing methamphetamine, and or they didn't even think to bust me for eating all that marijuana, because it was medically indicated and I didn't have any impairment. Nobody thought to stop me. And so you can't take somebody's child away and pretend like you caught them and they went to prison and the child can't see anymore. And that child either, she's 7, almost 7, she'll be 7 in May, my birth daughter. And she either wandered off into the dairy farm next door where the county sheriff's family owns property, and they like to put snare traps out for coyotes. And we've had 2 dogs over the last 8 years get caught in them, almost die, and require extensive vet bills that weren't even charged. It's country. It's just like, what fucking ever? You almost killed our dog, you know, like, don't. So those things are still there. So either, hey, talking to that, what's going on?
Online once in a while.
I do. I'm trying to do normal things so that I can be normal again.
Are you recording right now?
I am recording right now. I was telling a story.
Hi.
Pasati atram dos pa.
That is so
rosy. Yeah. I have money saved up to condition my saxophone, so she's gonna go in and have all the pads.
Oh, yeah.
And get tuned.
It's time, huh?
Yeah, and get shined up and prettied up and everything. So it's been a little while.
Yeah, there's so many moving parts.
There is, and there's a few that don't work, and I can make them sound almost like they're low, they're too, like, they're off, and so I have to play different notes than that are normal, and I'm already transposing in the first place, so I see some of them as kind of like wah-wah effects, because they're messed up, so
you
like electronic
you gotta
things.
Push them out. Yeah.
I just work it. I'd like an electric one, I think that would be fun.
Is that a
actually, it was sold kind of as a toy.
I know.
The Casio one.
I've seen that before.
I have one.
Do you?
Yeah, it needs a squeak removal.
Uh-huh.
But the beauty of that thing is it's got a MIDI out.
Yeah.
So you can play your keyboard with it.
Oh, that's cool.
So I had it trained up where I could tone the notes and trigger the drum machine.
Yeah.
And if I held the note, it would do pads on the synth.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. So I can whack the snare drum on the...
That's awesome.
Yeah, well.
I've seen one of those before, and it looks cool. So they need to do something more like that. It's fun.
So I use the audio out on it to drive vocoders, side chaining.
Uh-huh.
You know what that is?
No.
Okay. You know what vocoder is?
No, I don't know much about it.
Okay. I'll give you the quick and dirty.
Okay.
You got a signal going through. You send a signal on the side to affect what's coming through.
Okay.
So it's sort of like a wah-wah, except the wah-wah is working in line.
Uh-huh.
Changing the tone.
Yeah.
As you go. But a vocoder uses all sorts of inputs to change all kinds of outputs.
Okay.
Surgery, and it got billed to me. I don't know how, but I haven't had surgery. I need hand surgery, but I haven't had hand surgery. And you'd think people would want a sax player and an artist to be able to use her hand. But anyway, whoa, what was I talking about? Sit down for a minute. I'm just done performing. Yes, I consider that performing, because lots of people are watching me. At least if they don't the first time, they might the second time. I'm off track. Anyway, things have been rather difficult. I don't know what the fuck I was just talking about. I have to go to the bathroom, and that's really what I'm thinking about. They said that I had some sort of arrest warrant out like a few months later and held me for 4 more days. And so I spent some time in jail so they could act like they were holding me for a psychiatric hold and observation, and they might have even billed it as a hospital stay, and that's why it's not showing up in the legal system. But regardless, I spent 11 days there, and it was not very fun, and it wasn't very nice, and they were quite mean to me. And one of the guards was my the first friend I ever met when I moved to Crestwell in second grade, that showed me around and to introduce me to all of her friends. It was her husband, so that was really, it was just fucking awesome. So he got to harass and, you know, me the whole time and call me out by my name and make sure that he didn't just call me by my number like everybody else did. So we got a highlighter name. So apparently people got into paperwork by saying that there was some sort of production, a filming production, and they needed the documents, and then they just kept using them like they were real, and it's fucked with my life, and I'm tired of it. So hopefully those things get fixed quickly, then I can be happy again and tell funny stories and shit that Saturday Night Live can rip off and make lots of money off without paying me a dime. Until recently. can't steal it anymore. They blocked it. It'll just accrue until I get permission. Nobody else to get their little hands into the cookie jar. I'm sorry. You'll have to come and ask for it the proper way.